Alright, Robo Raptor doing some donuts there.
So, inspiration for this model came from this video here. Put a link in the description. It's a very cool robot. The video doesn't explain a whole lot, but it does look like the legs have some flex to them. They're probably made out of carbon fiber.
It looks like it's got a big flywheel right in the center that's spinning independently of the motion of the legs. That's probably to give it some balance in the forward and backward direction. Also, check out the rubber bands on the feet for shock absorption.
Here they say that the robot doesn't use computers and sensors to balance, but in this shot, it's using much older technology, a string. And in this other shot, it's held up by acrylic panels. This robot is stable on the front to back axis, but it's not stable on the side to side axis, and that's why they're holding it up. And that really points to the problem of making a bipedal robot. When you lift one of the legs up, the robot wants to tip over that way, so the leg's not going to come up off of the ground, or the robot's just going to fall over toward that leg that's being lifted up. So here with Lego Raptor, when one leg goes down, it's pushing hard enough to lift that side up and tip the model over to the other side, so that the center of gravity shifts to the other side. As the other leg comes down, the mass of the model is right over that leg. Of course, really big feet also help. And here's a few more shots of Lego Raptor doing his thing.